everyone. Welcome to Neighborhood Watch, where we are exposing the crime, corruption, greed, murder, bribery, extortion, and homicide going on in the community, one neighborhood at a time. And this is a collective reading of sorts, I guess you could say. I will be clarifying cards here. For this reading today and going forward, we are using my 200 card Murder, She Wrote deck, handwritten by myself. I instinctually grabbed this one. I just divided the deck into two halves, so we have something more manageable to work with here, but this is what it looks like, okay? And I'm gonna get started in just a minute here. Private readings are available now. I have opened up my scheduling page. For those of you who would like to book a private reading with me, you can definitely do so. Just click up in the right-hand corner or down below in the description box. If you click up in the right-hand corner, there'll be a little eye in the sky. Just click that eye. That will actually take you to my scheduling page where you can book a reading at your convenience. I wasn't too sure if I was going to do a reading today, but I also wanted to do a reading yesterday, but that didn't happen, so I don't know. I guess timing is a little bit, it's off for me for some reason. I'm not sure why, but we're getting back into it. Yeah, what I meant to say is I like to do these more frequently. It's just, I could not get any readings out yesterday. And, you know, once you start a 72-hour forecast cycle, it's kind of like you're in a rhythm of doing a reading every 72 hours. So I kind of got myself into a little bit of a pattern there, and I'm attempting to break the pattern, but it is harder than I thought, I guess, is what I meant to say. Anyway, long-winded answer there. Just wanted to let you guys know that I really did want to get readings out more frequently. It's just I'm in like a little bit of a 72-hour pattern, I guess. So I don't know, maybe that's for the best at this point. We're using the Steampunk Tarot deck today by Barbara Moore to clarify. Cards and illustrations are by Allie Fell here. For more information, you can visit Llewellyn.com. There's some websites there. Llewellyn.com or Facebook.com/Llewellynbooks. I don't know what's going on with my hair today. But we're going to roll with it, and not that anyone cares. Okay. All right, let's see. Spirit, what do you want to expose in terms of this reading? Neighborhood Watch, Spirit, Neighborhood Watch. What needs to come out? What do you want to expose in terms of... Okay, We have a towing service. So someone could work for a towing service. Someone could have their car towed. Or this is what's going on right now. Be a particular towing service of importance. Okay. Someone could be having their car towed or needing to call a towing service. Rage. Yeah, someone could be very upset about a towing service right now. Feeling a lot of rage, wrath, resentment. Maybe someone's car got towed here. I'm hearing a legal towing service. I heard Victory Auto Wreckers. Are they still around? I heard that they, it's a very corrupt business organization, actually. I've heard that they... Maybe they went under. I don't know. Whatever you do, don't call Victory Auto Wreckers. Victory. Victory, I'm hearing Victory Auto Records or Victory Auto Insurance. Okay. Definitely do not call them. I don't even think they're still around. I'm seeing a smash and grab here. Okay, so someone's storefront could be robbed. Be an armed robbery as well. Smash and grab. Towing service, rage, smash and grab. Incense just fell onto my table. I'm going to keep it far away from the cards, please. Anything else, Spirit? What else is going on here? Okay, something going on with a parking attendant. So this is all kind of, we're talking about cars, parking, smash and grab. So a parking attendant may have called a towing service, which really is pissing someone off here. There, in addition, there could be a smash and grab going on somewhere in the background. I'm not sure what how the smash and grab relates, but the parking attendant and towing service and the rage kind of all goes together somehow. What else? Oh no. Eliza Fletcher? Okay. So first of all, Eliza Fletcher is, I did a reading on her case a while back. Was it this time of year? I think it would have been late August or so. So we're a little bit early in terms of the anniversary of her passing, her murder. But yes, the Eliza Fletcher case is closed, I'm pretty sure. Now, Eliza Fletcher was a teacher, preschool teacher living in Memphis, who was a runner, a jogger, and I guess one morning she was going on one of her regular runs. She was abducted, kidnapped by an individual who violently forced her into his vehicle, probably drove her around, and who knows what happened in there. Probably nothing good. I'm pretty sure she was assaulted. Physically assaulted and left for dead somewhere in South Memphis somewhere, and where her body was found a few days later. But yes, Eliza Fletcher was a white female, probably in her 30s or 40s. Like I said, she was a runner, a jogger, preschool teacher, came from a wealthy family. Well-to-do family, multi-generational, sort of probably, I would say, millionaires of some kind. Anyway, I don't know what she has to do with all of this, but of course there could be a similar situation. We'll have to clarify that. Someone's name could be Eliza, or someone could have a last name with a Fletcher. But Eliza Fletcher is coming through here for some reason now. That could be a warning as well. Something flipped over. Okay, something happening on the north side. So this could be happening on the north side of your city. Someone's city here, happening on the north side. Did Eliza Fletcher live on the north side of Memphis? I believe she did. Where she lived a few miles from the university there, which is where she was, where she had a sort of a route where she was jogging. Something is a coincidence. There's a couple of other cards that came out here. So, I'm not sure if I'm going to take the next couple of cards, because what I'm getting here is possibly an assault of some kind taking place. Definitely, there could be a towing service called. This could be happening on the north side. I'm also seeing a smash and grab. Something is a coincidence. The next card that came out was this card, which is... yeah, that's what it is. It says anal beads. I don't know what the... We have organs. Someone could be a Wiccan. Listens to the wrong people. Ghost plane. Burglary. Serial cheater. Auto theft. Catholic, corrupt, sex worker, we have Leo, we have scooter, Russian, liquid, and third party. So that's a lot of cards that just came out all of a sudden here. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with these cards. But, I mean, this could be the 12 minutes on the clock here. This might be a shorter reading if I don't go in and clarify. Give me a moment here, guys. Someone could be a Wiccan. Someone has taken the wrong advice. It's possible that some more evidence is going to be found in the Eliza Fletcher case, even though I do feel like that case is pretty much shut and closed. They already apprehended the person, but there could be something going on with anal beads and organs. I don't know. Those cards just flew out. So also we have Wiccan, listens to the wrong people, corrupt. I'm seeing a ghost plane, an auto theft, and a burglary here. We saw a smash and grab. We also have something with a towing service and a parking attendant. So, of course, there could be something going on with an auto theft. There could be a Leo that's a sex worker. We have a third-party situation. Something is corrupt. Someone could be Catholic. I'm getting something about vodka or Russian liquid, or Russians doing something with something liquid. Or Russians could be liquidating. Someone is a serial cheater here. Whoever's a serial cheater could listen to the wrong people. I'm picking up Libra's energy. We have a scooter. So someone could be using a scooter here to do whatever this is on the north side of someone's city, town, or whatever. I don't know if I'm going to go in and clarify these cards at this point, because I'm kind of feeling like Something is weird. Something is strange. Okay, let me go over this again. Ghost plane. Okay. I'm getting something about a spiritual plane of existence, not an actual ghost plane. I'm getting like ghosts. Picking up something about auto theft, a rape or an assault, possibly of a white woman here between the ages of 30 and 40 on the north side. They're saying, careful who you listen to. There's a burglary as well. This could very well be Eliza Fletcher's spirit coming through, in which she could be communicating in the manner in which she was assaulted. Unfortunately, also something may have recently happened to her vehicle or a car or vehicle or the car that she was abducted in. That's another possibility, but there's something going on with the sex worker here. I'm getting on the north side. There could be a Leo involved. Leo's coming up. We have Leo, you know, obviously we're going into Leo season eventually. Someone could be a Catholic. Someone could be a Wiccan. Something is corrupt. Yeah, there's a third party here. Yeah, someone's a serial cheater. Someone scoots around on something here. Someone's got a scooter. Something is a coincidence. Is something a coincidence? No, it's not a coincidence. Russian liquid. Russian liquid. Someone could be involved in some sort of organ trafficking. I heard sales. Russians could be involved in organ trafficking. Let me break the deck again. Anything else? Organs. So I would say, if you have like a route that you do every day, like say you at the same time every day go for a jog, say at the same time every day you go for a run, maybe you are training for a marathon, who knows? I would just be careful. I feel like there's a parking attendant that could be like watching women joggers, someone that is a very observant. Okay. I also feel like someone is watching to see, like, to tow someone's car here. I'm getting a very sadistic person. I feel like someone could be assaulted or raped in a very sadistic manner. I'm getting something about a third party. Someone is a cheater, a serial cheater. There could be a Wiccan and a Catholic in a relationship, or a Wiccan and a Catholic are involved somehow in something. Um, For the location, I'm getting on the north side. Yeah, in general, I would just say be careful if you are out and about. If you are a female jogger, whatever, there could be a situation like that coming up. The DEA may be involved. Someone could be under the influence. I also have Virgo here. Alrighty then. Well, I think I'm going to leave it there, guys. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time.